8 minus half, plus half 8 minus half. So this is the first, then it will be added with some other coefficients. Look here, I did 1 half minus 1 half, and it is giving me this 1 half. If I consider the other m values on 1-0 column, I am doing. So on 1-0 column, the other m values are minus half and plus half. So I will write again, their value is 1 over 2 square root. So 1 over 2 square root, and then half half are the values of J1 and J2. Look here, the M1 value is minus half while the M2 value is plus half. So this is minus half, sorry, I will try to write with another color. So minus half and plus half. You got it? Is there any other possibility? There is no other possibility. 1-0 is the coupled state. Quadrants are the coupled. You can practice to write 1-1 state. So 1-1 state, the value is 1 square root, and you will go to plus half, you see here, plus half, and here you will get, instead of 1 over 2, you will get 1, because here the value is 1 square root, clear? Okay, we will take enough time on this one, so that you understand and then we will move forward. Don't worry. It's a bit tricky, but it's easy to understand. The very first thing. So don't forget to keep these rules in mind. The very first thing, we will have to read the table. How we can read the table? These are the four steps to read the table. The Clebsch Gordan coefficients, these are the four rules to read the table. The very first one, to locate a table, because the table are having many branches. To locate the table, first look at the J values. The J values will be written like this. So 1 over 2 cross 1 over 2, it means this is according to our example, J1 and J2. So we located a table. Clear? Now, we will have to locate our coupled state, means the column. And I am writing for 1-0 state, coupled state. So 1-0, it should be a column. If I was locating for 1-1, then I will consider this column. I am writing this for 1-0 state. So first I will locate the column here in the table, and it is 1-0. Clear? Now 1-0 is the column. This is the value of it. This is the coefficient which is associated with the 1-0. And that is to be square rooted. So I wrote the very first coefficient is 1 over 2 square root. And then this is the M1, M2, means both are up. Clear? So M1 and M2. For M1 and M2, I will have to go to the specific row. And these are the specific rows because I am taking this value. So the value means I will come this way and then this way. So I will have plus half and minus half. So the M1 value is plus half, M2 value is minus half. Here, again in this column, I am having another value here. So it means 1 over 2 is again the value, and M1 is minus half, M2 is plus half, minus half and plus half. So what I did, I wrote the coupled state in the form of product states. This is just like writing are in terms of x, y, and z unit vectors, because those are the product bases. Clear? If I'm having the coupled state, I can write this thing in the uncoupled state. But if I will have to go from here to here, what can I do? Means what I did, I moved from here to here. So these are the unitary transformation. Unitary transformation means from this you can go to this, and from this you can go to this with multiplication by 1. Right? Unitary transformation. Just like you do in matrices, multiplying it with a unit matrix. You got the unitary matrix, you got the identity matrix as well. Similarly, from here you can go here as well. Just like you wrote that y coefficient was equal to y unit vector dot r. So r was the coupled form. Here it we wrote. R is the coupled, while y was the uncoupled. So you can go from here to here as well. Like if you want now to write, for example, the state which is both with spin down, like both with spin down here. So both the spin down state, how can I write it? 1/2, and 1/2 will be the GVUs, while minus half will be the M values. Clear? So it is this state. Minus half. Both the spins are down. M1 value, M2 value, both are down. Now I want to write this. This is a product state. Clear? Because individual J and M are clear here. I want to write this thing in the form of coupled state. So what is the coupled state which is associated with two spin down states? 1 minus 1, right? Okay. 1 minus 1, these are the capital J and capital M values. And capital J, capital M are associated with a column. So first locate 1 minus 1. Where it is? 1 minus 1. Here. The column is here. And its value, its coefficient, the CG coefficient for this value is 1. So I can write that 1, and then I can write the state 1 minus 1. Clear? The value 1 square root, because this is the coefficient 1 square root. And then I can write the row. The row is actually means this is the column 1 minus 1. This is the row minus half. So if I want to write 1 minus 1, now on the other side, what it will be? Minus half, and here 1 minus 1 I will write here, here I will write 1 square root, here I will write half, minus half, and sufficient. Clear? You got it? Okay, I did not the right example here. Because here we are writing 1, 0, we should have written in this form. So let me write this way. I want to write the coupled state 1 minus 1. I want to write 1 minus 1. This is the coupled state. Now I will go to the column, because this is the G capital M. So I will go to the column 1 minus 1. The very first thing that I will write the CG coefficient. And the CG coefficient is this square root. So this is 1. Right? And then I will write the product states, the product bases. So to the 1, I will go to the row. And M1 is minus half, M2 is minus half. So I will write 1, and then half, half are the G values, right? And the M1 value is minus half, M2 value is minus half. You got it? So you can come from the product state to a coupled state, and from the coupled state to a product state. And wherever you are having the 1-0 combination, like 1-0 and 1-0, here 2 CG coefficients will be involved. And in the 1-1 and with the 1-1, you will have the 1 coefficient involvement. Now let's come, make yourself understand. I want to write 1-1 state. Okay? The coupled 1-1 state. So I will go to the column in which I will have 1-1 state. This is the column. So the CG coefficient for this will be 1. Square root. Don't forget the square root. So the CG coefficient is the square root of 1. And the M1 is because the row plus half plus half. Clear?
Yes,
sir. You got it?
Yes, sir.
Anyone who is having a doubt, because the spin half particles are like this.
So
what about
0-0?
What about 0-0? Okay. So this is the 0-0 column. 1-0 column we have done. This is the 0-0 column. So what will be the CG coefficient? It will be 1 over 2 square root minus 1 over 2 square root. And this will be the combination. Now, if you get 0-0, 1 over 2, you will have, should I write? Okay, let me write this one from the table. You want to write 0-0. So capital J is 0 and capital M is 0. So this is 0-0 column. Now the very first thing, I will have to write the CG coefficient. So the CG coefficient is 1 over 2. So I will take the square root of this. 1 over square root 2. Now I will write the state. And the state is J1 and J2 value are clear to you. They are 1 over 2 and 1 over 2. So I will write 1 over 2 and 1 over 2. Now for the M values, I will have to follow the row. So what is the row? Here. Plus half and minus half. Clear? So I will write plus half and minus half. Now I am not writing with another color because now you understand. Is there any other coefficient involved? I will have to come here. In 0-0 column, I am having minus 1 over 2 as well. So it will be minus 1 over square root 2. And then what will be the combination? 1 over 2 and 1 over 2 are for the J's. And here, this is minus 1 over 2, so what we are doing? Minus 1 over 2 and 1 over 2. So minus 1 over 2 and 1 over 2. Clear? So this way you wrote a coupled state into product states. We found 1-0 combination, we found 1-1 combination, we discussed somewhere 1-1 combination, we discussed the 0-0 combination. Should I write the 1-1 as well? In order to remove any doubt here. So the 1-1 combination, the 1-1 coupled state. First, I will go to the 1-1 column. So one column is this one.
Yes.
What is the CG coefficient?
One.
The CG coefficient is 1. So 1 over square root, it is 1. And then I will write the state 1 and now the row. And 1 and 2 values are along the row. So plus half and plus half. So I can write that this is half plus half, half plus half. Clear?
Yes.
Now if there's anyone who is not understanding, I will have to repeat this one. If you are not understanding. Yes? You are understanding?
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay. So you came to know how to read a table. Clear? Now, we will have to see something else here. If I look here, here is some empty space. Here is empty space. Here is empty space. So, the empty space here, there are values, but those values have been omitted. They are all zero entries. This is a complete entry, and this entry is such that it is a complete table. While we are having some entries here, the rest of the entries are zero. So we, you see here, we are having this value, clear? This is the CG coefficient. Then we were having these as the CG coefficients. If you remember, these were the CG coefficients. And this one is the CG coefficient. Are there any other CG coefficients? Okay. So this is like a matrix like this, this, and this. So what we get here, that it's a matrix like here, and then a matrix 2x2 matrix. This is 1x1. This is 2x2, and this is 1x1 again. So the CG coefficients are in this form. These will have some values. While here we will have 0, 0, and here we will have 0, 0, and all these values will be 0 and 0. Similarly, this way, all zeros. This way, all zeros. Clear? So we are not